Boker Tov, Botay Boker Tov. Today, Baruch Hashem, you arrived to Shabbat Kodesh. It's appropriate to say Shabbat Shalom Mevorach, Be'at Hashem to everyone. And Be'at Hashem to have a week full of bracha, full of atzlacha, and full of besiyat Dishmai to come to us, Be'at Hashem. You know, Botay, we know that Friday, we have the Sefirah of Yesod. We know the Zohar Kadosh says that on Friday, we actually prepare ourselves to receive the blessing for the entire week to come. That on Friday, we essentially are doing the preparation to receive the blessing. The Zohar Kadosh says that every Friday, HaKadosh Baruch Hu sends an abundance of shefa, of blessing, of light, to a man's home. That blessing actually protects the home, that blessing actually gives everyone health, makes a person find his zivuk faster, it uplifts a person's neshama. Because we know on Friday, a person even receives a second neshama. So with two neshamot, also need to double the amount of light, double the amount of food. So Hashem sends down to every single home an abundance of blessing. Zohar Kadosh said, this is the Zohar Kadosh in Bat Be'akel and Page Resh Gimel. Zohar Kadosh says that whenever Yetzer Hara sees that there is big blessing coming down to a man's home, what does Yetzer Hara do? He wants a piece of that blessing. Now we know the only place that blessing that the Shekhinah could sit is where? In a place that there is Simcha. Where it says that any place that there is no happiness, that there is no Simcha, the Shekhinah, the light, the Shefa, the blessing cannot sit there. So how does Yetzer Hara eat of that blessing? By very simple. By making the family, by making the people that are supposed to receive the blessing unworthy. By doing what? By making it bitter. So the Yetzer Hara will come to the husband and make the husband upset, and come to the wife, make the wife upset. Achida even goes as far as saying that on Friday, we need to be so careful that the husband should even run out of his house. That to eliminate any chance of the couple fighting. That Yetzer Hara on Friday, he comes down and he tries to fight, he uses all his power to make all of us in the home unworthy of receiving blessing. And the moment that blessing is no longer worthy of dwelling amongst us, that blessing sits in the air. And who's able to eat it? Who's able to absorb all that light? The Yetzer Hara. And he takes that light and makes himself even more powerful. So Abotai, on this week's Bezat Hashem, Friday, we need to make sure Abotai to keep a big simcha. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is sending down big bracha right now. But we need to be worthy for accepting. How are we worthy? By being happy, by praying, by singing, by organizing the Shabbat. The Zohar Kadosh says, and this is the minhag of a big mekubalim, that if a person wants always to keep blessing in his home, you should always have a piece of something ready for Shabbat. What does that mean? The Zohar Kadosh says that the moment you start to prepare yourself for Shabbat, you start to prepare the table of Shabbat, you start to prepare the food of Shabbat, you already start to receive that blessing. You already start to receive that light. The Mekubalim, what would they do? On Motzei Shabbat, when Shabbat would just end, they would already start to set the table for Shabbat. In order that already the week didn't even start and they already received the blessing. So Abotai, we are on a time where Hashem is sending big blessing. We need to be worthy to accept it. And especially B'at Hashem, the upcoming week is going to be the week of Gevurah, of strength. So everything we do needs to be with strength. Everything we do needs to be with force. We shouldn't sit on things. We get up, we go, and we do it. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu will give us the power and give us the atzlacha, the success, to achieve all what we want. So Shabbat Shalom Mevorach, a lot of bracha and atzlacha, and big b'siyata d'shmaya to come this week.